Recording audio properly when working in film and video production offers many different challenges. One test of quality microphones for your recordings is measuring its transient response. This isn't a particularly difficult topic, but it is definitely advanced. Most people, if they aren't doing professional audio work, probably haven't even heard of transient response before. But by the time this video is done, I'll give you a detailed explanation of this little known but important topic. Hi, I'm Jim Costa. I'm a videography, photography, and technology guru, but you can call me a dadographer. I've created many other videos on improving your photography, videography, filmmaking, video editing, audio recording, and technology skills, and I'll link to those in the description below, and both during and at the end of this video as well, so stay tuned. If you want to learn more, remember to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to be notified when I upload new videos. I upload every week, and I'll be uploading many more explanations of film, video, photo editing, audio, and technology topics. Stay tuned to the end to find out how to get my absolutely free DSLR mirrorless or interchangeable lens video camera cheat sheet that'll have you shooting photos and videos like a pro in no time. So, what is transient response? In the audio world, a transient is a short duration, high level peak of sound, such as a hand clap or a snare drum hit. Transient response refers to the ability of a microphone to respond to these transient peaks and faithfully reproduce the sudden waveforms that these sounds create. A sound transient is the steep wave front of the sound. In other words, the transient of the sound is the first impact of the sound before the sound falls off and begins to decay or die. So what does that mean? When we are in the Earth's atmosphere, sound waves travel through the air, kind of like waves on the water do. They work the same. We can't see them, but we can hear them. Whenever there's a sudden sound, like a clap, that creates a very loud sound initially, and the sound then tapers off after some time passes. It gets lower and lower and lower. And if you were to measure that graphically, like on an oscilloscope or on a graph, there's quiet, then there's a sudden peak of sound, and then it trails off. And the best quality microphones capture the full sound, the quiet before, the peak, sudden peak, and the trail off. Cheap quality mics don't react very quickly, so they miss that very initial high point of the sound and catch just a little bit on the slope afterwards. Well, that may be fine, but in most cases, if you're doing something like recording the sound for your film or a music video, or you're a musician, you're performing live, you want the entire sound to be reproduced and properly captured. Good microphones capture the whole sound. In other words, they're like always ready. There's not that millisecond of delay where they miss the peak at the very top from a sudden loud sound. That ability of microphones to capture that full sound wave, the initial loud sound that you saw on the peak and then the trail off, is what transient response is. Good transient response is especially important when recording acoustic instruments. This is one case where it's extremely important for one to have equipment that is able to capture as much of the initial transient as possible, you know, the very beginning of the sound, and all its accompanying delicate details down the road. You may not have heard of this subject before, but you've definitely understood and heard its results. For example, the faithful recording and reproduction of sound source transients makes the strong rhythm elements in rhythm and blues and pop recordings much more dramatic. Dynamic and condenser microphones respond differently to transients and therefore have different transient responses. For any microphone to convert sound into electrical energy, the sound must move through the mic's internal diaphragm. The transient response of a condenser microphone is quick and accurate due to the light mass of the diaphragm. In contrast, dynamic microphones have a heavy diaphragm along with the additional weight of the coil of wire. Therefore, it takes longer for the diaphragm to react to sound waves due to the effects of inertia, hence causing a less accurate recording. Generally, a dynamic microphone's transient response is not as efficient as the transient response of a condenser microphone. This means that condenser microphones are better suited to instruments with sharp attacks or extended high-frequency outputs, like, for example, drums. However, condenser microphones are not able to withstand extreme sound pressure levels due to their high sensitivity. Dynamic microphones are able to withstand high sound pressure levels due to their robust diaphragms, making them more suitable choice for instruments such as kick drums or bass guitars. The truth of the matter is, unless you're an audio recorder or you're a very picky, musician, you're probably not going to have to worry about this for just creating most videos. However, if you do those things, or you plan to do those things, it's important to understand this topic so that you can use the best type of microphone for the instruments or singing that's being done, and therefore you get the best recordings, making your overall projects sound much better. So if all this is making sense to you, but I've got it in the comments section below. My question of the day is, have you ever encountered poor audio recordings for any of your projects? If you have, leave a comment below and let us know, and also let us know how you solved the problem. Would you like to learn more about your camera settings to get you shooting like the pros do? Well, I've created an absolutely free cheat sheet for you on all the best camera settings for your DSLR, mirrorless, and interchangeable lens video cameras that will show you the settings that will make your photos and videos absolutely fantastic in no time. The link to get that cheat sheet is just below in the video description. I've also created cheat sheets on other topics, such as editing video, and even now offer training courses on editing video using Adobe Premiere Pro, which is part of the Adobe Creative Suite, and very soon I'll have others training courses as well. The link to get those cheat sheets and training courses is below in the description. Would you like to see more videos like this? If so, please follow my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, for many more. Do you think what you saw was great? Like it. Do you have an opinion? Please comment below. If you know someone who could benefit from the information that I provided, then please share the video. Do you want to learn even more? If so, then connect with Jim Costa Films on social media and online on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and the web. I currently have over 4,300 videos on my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, so feel free to check out many of my other videos for great tips and suggestions. If you follow me for a while now, you may know that I have a community of photographers, videographers, and filmmakers just like you on Facebook, where I share pro tips and tricks. It's called Video Producers and Content Creators. I love new members who want to share their work and learn from others, or who want to help others who have questions. Now, you're going to find a link to that group in the description below, so feel free to join it, where you can learn even more.